Listening Library presents Who Was Gandhi? By Dana Meachen Rau. Read for you by Vikas Adam. Who Was Gandhi? On March 12, 1930, 60-year-old Mohandas Gandhi set out from his home in Ahmedabad, India, with 78 men and women at his side. They walked 240 miles along winding, dusty roads. It took 24 days in the hot sun to reach the town of Dandi on the western coast. Gandhi spoke with villagers all along the way. By the end of his journey, several thousand people had joined him. When the marchers arrived in Dandi, they prayed. The next morning, April 6th, on the shore of the Arabian Sea, Gandhi picked up a lump of salt from the mud. By doing so, he broke the law. This peaceful act was powerful. It united many Indians against the unfair Salt Act laws. The Salt Acts stated that Indians could not gather, make, or sell their own salt. Instead, they had to buy it from the British, who ruled India from 1858 to 1947. Salt was a basic need in Indian households to flavor food. After Gandhi's small but brave action, Indians all over the country began to gather and sell their own salt. Gandhi's salt march started India on a path to freedom from British rule. Mohandas Gandhi fought for freedom in India, but he did not fight with weapons. He believed words and actions were more powerful than violence. Above all, he had a simple message: to find truth through love and caring for others. People called him Mahatma, which means great soul. Chapter 1. Child Groom. Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi was born on October 2, 1869, in Porbandar, India. Porbandar was a small state on the western coast of a very large country. Mohandas, called Mohan by his family, grew up with his mother, father, two half-sisters from his father's previous marriages, oldest brother Lakshmidas, sister Raliatben, and brother Karsandas. Mohan was the youngest. His father, Karamchand, was the Diwan, or political leader, of Porbandar. The large family lived well with servants in a three-story house. Mohan grew up in a country with deep Hindu traditions. His mother, Putlibai, was especially religious. Every day she went to the temple for worship. She prayed before meals. Sometimes she fasted or gave up food to show her devotion to God. During one period of 4 months during the rainy season, Putlibai said she would not eat until the sun came out. Gandhi later said, "We children on those days would stand, staring at the sky, waiting to announce the appearance of the sun to our mother." His mother's devotion left a big impression on little Mohan. He saw her as a saint. When Mohan turned 7, his family moved from Porbandar to the more inland city of Rajkot. At school, Mohan was an average student and extremely shy. "My books and my lessons were my sole companions," he said. As soon as school ended, he would run home. He did not want to have to talk to anyone or risk someone making fun of him. Mohan was also very fearful as a child and even into adulthood. He was afraid of thieves, snakes, ghosts, and most especially, the dark. Hindu parents arranged the marriages of their children. When Mohan was only 7, his parents had betrothed, or promised, him to a girl. Kasturbai was the same age as Mohan. She was the daughter of a merchant in Porbandar who was a good friend of Mohan's father. When Mohan and Kasturbai turned 13, they would be married. Later in life, Gandhi was very outspoken against the idea of child marriage. "I can see no moral argument in support of such a preposterously early marriage," he wrote. But during his own wedding, Gandhi enjoyed himself. "Everything on that day seemed to me right and proper and pleasing," he said. "The wedding was a huge party with many guests, colorful parades, and much celebration. The bride and groom were fond of each other." But marriage was not easy. Mohan and Kasturbai had to learn how to be a husband and a wife. The preparations, wedding, and new married life interrupted Mohan's studies. He had to take a year off before he returned to school. Religion in India. Hinduism is strongly linked to the people and culture of India. This set of beliefs and traditions does not embrace one single god or prophet. It does include the belief in a universal spirit, called Brahman, who can take the form of many different gods and goddesses. Hinduism is divided into many sects and subgroups, of which Vaishnavism and Shaivism are the largest and most popular. Gandhi's family members were Vaishnava Hindus. They worshipped the god Vishnu. In Gandhi's time, about one quarter of the population in India practiced the religion Islam. Islam is the belief in one God, Allah. Its followers are called Muslims, and they study the teachings of the Prophet Muhammad. Muslims in India lived mostly in the northeast and northwest of the country until the creation of the country of Pakistan in 1947. In high school, Mohan enjoyed pleasing his teachers. Outside of school, he tried to do the right thing as well. But one friend tried to get him to go against his beliefs. Mohan and his family were vegetarians. The friend told Mohan that eating meat would make him stronger and help him get over his fears. Mohan met his friend in secret by a river and tried meat for the first time. He got sick. He had nightmares. But he continued to eat meat for about a year. He didn't like lying to his family. He finally realized that his friend and meat were not good for him. As a young man, Mohan had many responsibilities. This included caring for his sick father when he was not at school. His father died when Mohan was only 16. More sadness arrived when Mohan and Kasturbai's first baby passed away after only a few days. In 1887, Mohan completed high school. He tried college, but found no interest in the lectures. He didn't feel he was ready. After only one semester, he came home. A family friend suggested that Mohan go to England. He said it was easier to become a lawyer by attending school there. By studying law, he could become a diwan like his father. Mohan agreed. It was not common for a young man from Rajkot to travel all the way to England for schooling. Gandhi had always been shy and fearful. Now he was headed for a new adventure far away from home. The British Raj. In 1600, the East India Company, EIC, was founded by London merchants trading in the East Indies. The EIC took over political rule in India by defeating the Bengal troops and their French allies in the Battle of Plassey. In 1857, Indian troops rebelled against the rule of the EIC. After the rebellion was defeated, the British Raj, Raj means rule, controlled the country. Indian princes could still make some laws for their local areas, but a British viceroy ruled the whole of British India for nearly 100 years. Many Indians wanted equality and were dissatisfied with British rule. India finally became independent in 1947. Chapter 2.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.